Take me back to the day that you, I guess, realized or that you were notified that you earned this $8 million contract from the federal government. What was going through your mind when you received this contract? Which was your first one, right?
Yeah. It was the first one. It was like it worked, right? It was like bananas, right? Because you have to recognize that we went from crisis to victory overnight. Because like most neophyte business owners, when you start a business, I did what we all do, right? I got my little money. We actually took out an equity line of credit on the house. And I did everything to look like I was in business before I got my first book of business, right? I got the mahogany desk and the office downtown with the receptionist and the business card. I had a website that was the bomb diggity before websites were even popular. So from that perspective, when I made my way to DC to go and try and get some business, I needed that business. I needed that business desperately. So the relief that occurred when this shot in the dark that I had studied myself approved to find work was significant. It was an opportunity for me to exhale. It was an opportunity for me to get mama's eyes off of my back because she had been staring at me because, hey, man, you got this Afro sheen and this dual fluid. You're going to do this business and it ain't working, right? So it was a tremendous amount of personal relief when that event occurred.
Wonderful, wonderful. And in one moment, I want to get deeper into why Black people, African Americans need to dig deeper into the industry of federal government contracting. But before I do, I just want to remind the people who are just coming in, I'm here with Walter Cotton III. Walter is the managing partner of the Cotton Exchange, which is a boutique consulting firm focusing on helping contractors increase their position with the federal government. And today we're talking all about how Black business owners are making billions with a B, billions of dollars through federal government contracting. So if you like the information that we're sharing today, please go ahead and press the thumbs up button on YouTube. Also, please make sure that you share this video with others who would benefit from this knowledge and subscribe to our YouTube channel if you would like to receive more videos like and interviews like the one that we're doing today with Brother Walter Cotton. So, Walter, I want to get specific in regards to the opportunity for Black people in the United States. What does that look like in regards to government contracting? So why should Black people really be focusing government contracting as a way to earn money for their business?
There are two significant reasons. The first of which is because you own an organic preference that gives you an advantage in capturing federal contracting that people just aren't telling you about, right? Just your social uniform gives you the opportunity to go and make a demand call against a $300 billion budget. And I said that with a B. I said it, I'm not taking it back. Research it, disprove that particular fact. There is a $300 billion market opportunity that is waiting for you to apply your natural gift against. That's the first reason why you want to take advantage of it. The second reason is because it is one of the most controlled ways for you to ascend into entrepreneurialism. A lot of people want to start businesses. Challenges that the success of the business is dependent on your ingenuity, right? Can you come up with the right idea to fit the right location at the right time so it can go viral and blow up? Well, the probability of that, just based on the attrition rate of small businesses in this country, the vast majority of them fail within the first 36 months of opening the door. The answer to that is not likely. But when you take a controlled environment that has a proven outcome event like you experience in government contracting, take a preference, a advantage in operating within that space, it only makes logical sense if you can crack the code and there is enough demand for you to take a more controlled approach to a business venture. Now, the wonderful thing about the federal government is that they buy everything. So there's not an area of business that you can consider that the government doesn't already procure services or procure products in. So if you are contemplating business, right, would advocate that you don't go off on that wild Geppetto idea that you have, right? You reserve that for a time when you have the available resources to risk, expend towards that wonderful dream. But you focus on a lane like government contracting because it provides you a controlled environment with a predictable outcome if you employ, right, the systems and procedures that are proven. Another example of a space that is akin to this that I would equally champion for neophyte entrepreneurs is the arena of franchise. Because again, you have a controlled environment, right? If you do this, you have a group of best practices that have been proven over that business model, right? If you employ those practices against the model, you're going to be successful. So those are the two primary reasons why I'm motivating, urging, dare I say, encouraging our community to look at government contracting. Because, and I'm going to say this is critical from my point of view. There are a lot of discussions moving around the country about revitalizing our community and economic development. But at the end of the day, unless we can find a way, right, to shift the economic equation in our community in a way that is advantageous for us, we are going to continue to be lenders and not borrowers, rather, and not lenders. This is a avenue that allows us an opportunity to go in and capture generational wealth. I'm talking about the kind of generational wealth that you have the ability to pass down to up to five generations of your family. And it is your social right under the Constitution of these United States of America. So my call to action here is for us to take advantage of this point in time opportunity, because people of color aren't the only ones that it's available to, right? It's also available to Asian Americans. It's available to other preference groups. So the alarm that I'm sounding, since I wrote the legislation that makes it available, is for people who wear my social uniform to go into that vault and get your desired share now. Be the early adapter, be the disruptor that you're looking for.
Yeah, no, I mean, I think that's a great point, especially talking about other groups having access to this same pool of capital as well.